Hello viewers, we are by the sidelines of an analyst briefing for ZPI where we have seen the presentation of a strong set of financials for the half year ended 30 June 2019. Now joining me to discuss the performance is the managing director, Mr. Muvingi. Mr. Muvingi, good afternoon and congratulations on such a strong performance.
Thank you and good afternoon.
Beautiful. Now, of course, we will get into a discussion of the financials, but of interest would be the presentation of the Sawanga Mall, a project worth $15 million that you have been able to successfully launch. And of course, viewers, just behind us would be the live visuals, the live footage from the Sawanga Mall. You can see the vehicles parked there, as well as, of course, some of the tenants that have already moved into that particular structure. And once again, congratulations on this particular development. It's been quite an interesting journey. Just in a nutshell, would you want to take us through the nitty-gritties of the particular development where that is concerned?
I think for us, there's a strategic fit in terms of geography, in terms of sector, in terms of income diversification, and in terms of the move from CBD office to retail facilities. The tenants there, I think it's visual, it's fully lit. Most of the tenants, almost 70% or so, is already operating. By end of the month, we should have up to 90% of operation of the shopping center. And again, we decided to give you a live footage of what is going on there instead of a report of what's going on.
Interesting. Just briefly, would you want to talk about the financing of the particular project very briefly?
We funded with internal resources largely, including the forex component. As I was saying, we have not been able to get any funding from the banks. We have not gotten into the market to look for money. We have used our own internal resources by restructuring our assets to get to the money to import all the materials that we required.
Splendid. Now, to get into the financials, according to the results that we just pasted here, revenue scaling 124%, your profit after tax growing by about 60,000% on the back of fair value adjustments. Just in a nutshell, would you want to explain, or should I say, take us through the major drivers of the results that we've just presented?
I think what is clear from our results is that the quality of our revenue and also quality of the assets in terms of how they are hedging against the inflation, against exchange rate. But quality of our revenue, you see it through our exchange gains, in that most of our projects were denominated in dollars in terms of the disposals. And that's what you are seeing, the translation. As I said, most of the money that we used was internally generated. It's part of the project's income that we then used to fund Sawanga Mall, to fund the Blower project. And we've got a small component of the funding that we got from our traditional banker, ZB. But otherwise, in terms of that specific performance, it's your projects that angered that movement. And it's also that we had interbanked the rentals. In fact, initially before the change in policies, we had US dollar leases that we had simply interbanked to convert to closer to what our value has been. Going forward, we think you'll find that we'll be reviewing rentals on a quarterly basis. And that keeps us closer to our desired income level, as opposed to having all the money eroded. We've also put in turnover rentals on all the shops that are there. And we think we'll be able to track inflation and to track exchange rate as the operators increase their prices.
I realize. Now, of course, you've got several projects that are lined up. You've got the Lizard Lodge that is coming soon, as well as also the Adeline project, in addition to the Solbon one in Bulawayo. Mm-hmm. Would you want to explain, just in a nutshell, what perhaps we can look forward to, as well as how you intend to navigate? I mean, it's quite a turbulent macroeconomic mm-hmm. setup. What strategies have you in place to ensure that these projects become a success?
I think, like we've said, it's projects' material value chain is what makes it successful. If you don't understand, if you don't have control of the material value chain for any project, you lose it. Like your Sawanga Mall, we've not struggled, we've not stopped. From start to completion, we've always had materials delivered to the contractors. For the Lizard Lodge, as I said, it's most likely before end of next year, we should have the facility up and running. We've got structures in terms of funding that we have, internal resources, and loans from our traditional bankers. So again, that is secure. We already have some of the materials. We're going through the planning and regulatory aspects of it. But as I said, next year, by end of year, we should have the facility running. For Blawayo, it's Selborne Park student accommodation. The argument has always been that, are you not saturating the market? There's IDBZ, there's Zimri, there are private other operators, there are BOTs that are proposed on specific universities. But for us, it's the numbers in terms of enrollments and the numbers in terms of available beds. It simply tells you that the point of saturation is far, it's years away from now.
I realize. And then lastly, your flagship structure in Harare CBD, Fidelity Life Towers, concerns there in terms of the levels of occupancy. Your take?
I think it's only natural in that it's the periphery of the CBD that is decaying. And we have a very nice building in a wrong place. And for us, again, to retain the quality of the building, retain utilities working, and we think we have been able to attract some tenants back to the building. And if we retain it, we maintain it, we should be able to pick up when the economy stabilizes. At the moment, it's a learning curve. No one understands what's going on. And some of the tenants are just moving because they are closing business. And there's nothing we can do about it.
Well, thank you so much, Mr. Muvingi, and good luck with the ensuing financial season.
Thank you very much.
Much appreciated. Thank you, Vias, for staying with us. Ciao.